Okay, students, till yesterday we have, till last class we have discussed the Markovnikov's rule. So in this session we will discuss the anti-Markovnikov's rule. So this anti-Markovnikov's rule is also called as the peroxide effect, or it is also known as the Karasch effect. So in this particular reaction, whenever unsymmetrical alkene we have taken, so this unsymmetrical alkene, when subjected with the hydrogen bromide, not only hydrogen bromide, you can take any unsymmetrical reagent. But most of the time we discuss this anti-Markovnikov's rule using the only HBr in the presence of the peroxide. It gives haloalkanes. The main thing in this reaction is it follows free radical mechanism. And no rearrangement takes place. No rearrangement takes place. And the next one here is, whenever unsymmetrical alkene is added to the unsymmetrical, this unsymmetrical region, this unsymmetrical alkene, which is not written. Okay. So when unsymmetrical alkene is added with unsymmetrical reagent, the positive part of the reagent will be added to the double bonded carbon with a less number of hydrogens. So that is the anti-Markovnikov's rule. So I'll write down that when an unsymmetrical alkene is added with unsymmetrical reagent, the positive part of the reagent will be added to the double bonded carbon with less number of hydrogens. So this will be the product. Generally there will be no positive part, but if you split this molecule into the two positive parts, then you will get the H plus and Br minus, then H plus will be added to the double bonded carbon with less number of hydrogens. But in the presence of the peroxide, actually no positive part, no negative part exists. They all will be like free radicals. But the same anti-Markovnikov's rule cannot be observed in the presence of the symmetrical alkenes. Let's take some of the examples so that you will come to know. So first one is, let us take CH2 and CH2 alkene and add the HBr in the presence of the peroxide like ROR. So here you will get the CH3, CH2, Br. Even in the absence of peroxide also, you will get the same molecule. So that Markovnikov's rule and anti-Markovnikov's rule are not applicable to the symmetrical alkenes. So in the presence of the symmetrical alkenes, whether you use the peroxide or without peroxide, you will get the same product. Okay. And here I forgot one more point to mention. Peroxide effect is not observed with hydrofluoric acid, hydrochloric acid and hydroiodic acid. So if you use these molecules, you will get the only one type of the products usually. So let's take some of the examples. So your doubts, all doubts will be clarified by taking more and more examples. So let's go with the second example with some unsymmetrical alkene. CH3, CH double bond, CH2. Just you take only HBr here, and here HBr and peroxide, R2O2 or H2O2, whatever it may be. So in the absence of the peroxide, we get a molecule where more substituted hydrogen will go and add to the double bond carbon with more number of hydrogens, which is called the Markovnikov's rule. And here, in the presence of the peroxide, hydrogen, the same hydrogen goes and adds to the double bonded carbon with a less number of hydrogens. So that I will mention here the difference. In the absence of peroxide, hydrogen goes and adds to the double bonded carbon with more number of hydrogens, but here to the less number of hydrogens. So that the products just varies. Means, whatever the product we expect as the minor product in the Markovnikov's rule will be the major product in the anti-Markovnikov's rule. Anti-Markovnikov's rule. Here the intermediate is carbocation and here the intermediate is free radical. So you have to observe these two things. Whenever free radicals are there, there will be no rearrangement. Whenever carbocation is there, there will be rearrangement. So this is the basic thing. And rest of the examples, whatever we are going to write down, that only just a practice purpose, but a basic reaction is this one. So that I request you just remember this basic reaction and the key points of those reactions like this. And remember, rest of only for practice purpose and just to not be scared. Means just to, what we say, just to leave our fear about the remaining different type of the organic reactions and their molecules. So just practice. Now I'll just select another color pen to write down the practice questions here. I'm not writing the mechanism because the mechanism has been already discussed in the reaction mechanism concept. Just I request you just turn over those pages. So this is the first one. I am going to write down here CH3 and CH2. So HBr and H2O2. So once H2O2 you are using, you don't need to use the sunlight, because sunlight, H2O2, electricity, these are all free radical, all helps these reactions to carry out in the free radical mechanism. They just proceeds, they initiate the reactions or they direct the reactions towards the free radical mechanism. So this is the basic molecule. Then where I have to add this hydrogen? Here two double bonded carbon atoms are there. I must and should select the this particular double bonded carbon atom which is less substituted with, or which is having the less number of hydrogens, not the less substituted, it is more substituted or having the less number of hydrogen. Just so I will write down hydrogen here and remaining CH2 and Br. Now let's pick up another molecule. So in this molecule, just take HBr in the presence of the again peroxide. Any peroxide you can use, H2O2 or any something. So that now the molecule will be like this, because here hydrogens are not there, so that hydrogen go and add there and bromine will come to the carbon with less number of substituents. So let's take the third molecule. So where CH3, CH2, CH2 and PH, HBr. So in this particular, so okay, 1 minute, I'll take the like exam like now. What I am going to write down is, so I'll give some questions in just what I have written. So the questions are, draw the products. Draw the products including stereochemistry. Of each reaction, so now let's try to pick up, just a minute here. Okay, let's pick up some questions here. The first question is, what I had mentioned earlier, the same question I'm going to mention here, CH2 and pH, you just take the HBr. Okay, and the second question is, CH3 and HCl. First of all, let me discuss about these two compounds. Then we shall discuss about the other compounds. Okay. Stereochemistry is nothing but, here no particular stereochemistry is not there. Just you see how the stereochemistry exists, because here is the Markovnikov's rule. As per our discussion, carbocation will be formed over here and hydrogen will come and attack over there. So that the molecule what we expect is CH2 pH. Now once the carbocation is formed, then what happens? The carbocation is a planar in shape, so that Br- cannot approach the carbon from this side or from the that side. So two chances are there, so only those we have to write down. So if the bromide ion is approaching the carbocation from the back side, then what happens? The CH along with the hydrogen becomes CH3, no, it comes top CH3, and this becomes below the plane of the compound. Then there will be one more molecule, because it is a chiral carbon, so that we will get the enantiomers always pH. Now if the bromide approaches from the top, then what happens here? CH3 goes down and Br will be up. It is located over the above the plane of the compound. So the two compounds, actually is only one compound, compounds wise, but stereochemistry they said no, so that stereochemistry we are mentioning here. This is the only major compound stereochemistry we are mentioning, not the minor compound. Okay, and in this particular case, HCl is there. Same concept we can follow again. Here also, hydrogen goes and adds to the carbon with less number of, more number of hydrogens, and chlorine to the more number of substituents. So that the stereochemistry will be like this. Chlorine. So it is like this. Next, three. So third question is about the HCl here. So in this particular molecule, you cannot write down the stereochemistry. Why? Because after the addition of the hydrogen, both are methyl groups. Okay. So that it is not the chiral carbon. So that you can write down directly the molecule. You can write down only when there is a chance of producing the chiral molecule. but it is not a chiral molecule. Whether you are writing from the top or bottom, but see, if you write the chlorine from the top, 1-methyl goes down, means 1-methyl will be up. So that the molecule looks the same from the either directions. So let's take another molecule. H2O Br2. So what must be the product in this particular reaction? See, Br2 with water, it forms HOBr, no? So HOBr means, again, initially Br attacks from one side, OH from the other side. Okay, so just write down the, if Br is here top and OH will be down, only that we can write down. And fifth one, double bond CH2. Now just to take, means I am writing almost all the reactions what so far we have discussed in this particular lesson. So if this is an anti-Markovnikov's rule, then hydrogen goes to the carbon with more number of substituents and bromine goes to the carbon with less number of substituents. So again, there will be no stereochemistry. No stereochemistry exists here. Why? Because the bromine is going to add this to this particular carbon atom where two hydrogen atoms are there. So that you cannot write down any stereochemistry. And sixth molecule. HBr, HNu and peroxide. Let's take R2O2. same case here also. You can write down the Br here and rest of the case is same. Okay. So this is about the summary of the reactions and their stereochemistry, what we have discussed till today, from past 2 days. So now we are going to discuss another important concept of hydration reaction. So addition of water, or this reaction is also known as the hydration reaction. Okay, so generally hydration reaction I'll write down the matter for this. H2O undergo addition reaction with alkene in the presence of acid catalysts. Like H2SO4 to form alcohol. So just you take the alkene, add water, put H plus here. So here what happens, again hydrogen will be added to the one double bonded carbon atom and OH to the another double bonded carbon atom and producing the alcohol. This is alcohol, this is alkene. The question is, if alkene is symmetrical, then Markovnikov's rule not applied, and if alkene is unsymmetrical, then Markovnikov's rule is applicable. So I'll write down that also. If you take the symmetrical alkene, no Markovnikov's rule. So I'll write down each and every time that no Markovnikov's rule, MR rule I'll write, or MK rule. And if unsymmetrical is there, MK role is there, Markovnikov's role. Okay, and what are the intermediates? Because mechanism is generally plays a major role in most of the reactions and producing the products. The intermediate, I'll write down directly. Carbocation is the intermediate. So carbocation is the intermediate means automatically rearrangement reaction possible. Okay. So that hydrogen is, all these are not necessary remaining. Let's take some examples so that your doubts will be clarified. I am not writing the mechanism because the mechanism of this reaction is similar to that of HBR reaction, Markovnikov's reaction, till formation of HB, carbocation. Afterwards, in Markovnikov's role, Br minus attacks, here OH minus attacks. Only that is the difference. So just I'll take the examples. CH3, CH2, CH double bond, CH2. Almost all these reactions indirectly discussed in the mechanism, organic reaction mechanism concept. Just that's why I am revising these concepts. So H2 is just split into two parts, H plus and OH minus. H plus will be added to the double bond carbon with more number of hydrogens, and OH minus goes to the double bond carbon with less number of hydrogens. In the case of the unsymmetrical reagent, unsymmetrical alkene, so that the product is directly, you must remember this reaction, because this reaction and the reactions what we are going to discuss are so different and their products too. So not only this reaction, this complete reaction, hydration of alkenes. And let's take hydrogen here, CH3. So just take the H2O, H2SO4. Now H2O, hydrogen, where it will go and add here? OH minus to the more substituted carbon. So that here we will get the OH. So in this way, we can write down the products. I will take 2-3 examples. Then we shall go to the other type of the hydration reactions. Hydration reactions 3-4 are there. And each and every hydration reaction, we get the different products. These are so important in comparing the products and to understand the complete hydration process. So hydrogen again here, and OH minus to the more substituted carbon. Here no stereochemistry plays. Why? Because though carbocation is there, I am not writing the stereochemistry over here. Why? Because almost all the compounds what I had taken so far are unsymmetric, no chiral carbon atom. So I will take one more compound where chiral carbon atom will be there. Then what happens in such cases? A simple reaction, C2H5. Then you take CH2. Here you take some phenyl group. Just add H2. In the presence of H2SO4, hydrogen obviously comes over here, and once hydrogen comes over there, then what will be the problem for us? pH, let's write down same. If hydrogen is attacked over here, it becomes CH, then it becomes CH carbocation, right, positive charge. So carbocation means sp2 hybridization planar shape. So OH minus can approach from the front side or from the back side. If it approaches from the back side, methyl group comes front. Or if it approaches from the front, methyl groups goes to the back side. So that whatever the stereochemistry we are writing in the case of the Markovnikov's rule, same is applicable here also. Just only OH minus we are using. So that in coming examples, I may not discuss again the stereochemistry. Just remember this example. Stereochemistry of the Markovnikov's rule and this rule, both are, this reaction almost are same. Only there we use the bromide or halogen part. Here we use the OH part. end. Let's take 2-3 examples and we'll finish it off and go to the next hydration processes. Benzene, CH2, H2O, H2SO4, hydrogen here and OH minus there. Here also you can write down the stereochemistry because it is a chiral carbon. Next, some people, sometimes you may get the questions like this also. Instead of water, they may take alcohol. Again, H2SO4 will be used. Then people get just confused, or they may get of panic. Why suddenly this, from where this molecule, just similar to the water molecule. See, in water HOOH is there. So, in the place of hydrogen, they have taken just CH3. Remaining everything is same. Pattern is same. Okay. So, just you put, you take the OCH3 part instead of the hydrogen. Here, it becomes CH3O minus plus H plus. Okay. So, don't think that again OH minus comes and methyl groups goes and they adds there. Because I am just comparing the water molecule in this one. So, that it should not take like this. So, this is the one. And here OCH3. And other one is the methyl group. Let's take another one. So, this is the one molecule. Now, I am taking the ethyl alcohol. Just a concentrated sulfuric acid. OC2H5. Rest everything is same. So, hope you understood all these hydration process where we are adding OH to the double bonded carbon with less number of hydrogens. Now, similar things only we shall discuss, hydration process only, but using the different catalyst, not H2SO4. So, that is, if used mercury, there is one more reaction named oxymercuration. Demercuration. So, oxymercuration, demercuration reaction. It is a type of reaction, follows the same mechanism. But here carbocation directly will not be formed, but I will write down the product. That is, you just take the alkene. I am not writing the complete history of this reaction. You just take the alkene and add with water in the presence of mercuric acetate, HgOAC taken twice. This is just CH3COO. If you take two times and add Hg, this is called as mercuric acetate. In the presence of THF and water, second one is NaBH4 and OH minus. I will discuss why, what is the use of NaBH4. Okay. So, the use of NaBH4 is, it disconnects, or simply we can write it will reduce, it disconnects the mercury carbon bond. Mechanism, as I am not going to discuss, that's because for every reaction if you discuss the mechanism, it becomes confused. So, that you will get the alcohol similar to the hydration reaction. But I will compare the alcohol here and there are bit different. This alcohol is no rearranged product. It is not a rearranged product. I will take here. Why it is not rearranged product? Okay. If I take one example, you will get the complete idea. You just take this particular molecule, CH2, CH double bond CH2. So to this, if you add H2O in the presence of H2SO4, then the molecule what you are going to get here is this one. Hydrogen will be added here, positive charge will be formed here, but this hydrogen, this carbocation is more stable than this one, because this is a benzylic carbocation, that's why hydride shift takes place. So this is the rearranged product. But for that, if you add the same catalyst like HgOAC taken twice, H2O, THF, second one is NaBH4, OH-. Do you know what type of product you are going to get? This is the product. Means here, though carbocation is formed initially here, OH-, is not attacking, but it still waits to form the another stable carbocation. But in the case of the oxymercuration demercuration process, OH- attacks to the carbocation formed here. Actually, no carbocation, actually it is a intermediate product. So that you can say that hydrogen will be added to the carbon with more number of hydrogens and OH- to the less number of hydrogens. Okay. So now one more thing to be discussed here is this one particularly. They may use H2O. If they use, you get the alcohol. If they use alcohol here, you will get the ether. Alcohol means any alcohol they can use. That's why separately I had written. So while studying the reaction, you must observe very carefully about what type of reagent they had given, whether they had given H2O or alcohol or what. Okay. So some information I have to give here. See, I'll take a molecule. So many information you will get from this particular reaction. HgOAC taken twice, H2O, THF. This is the first one. So in second step, no doubt, NaBH4 and OH- comes. Okay. So you will get the molecule like this, CH3, CH, OH, and CH3. Okay. And next, you just observe this reaction very carefully, as this is a bit important. So second reaction, in this particular reaction, what I am going to mention is HgOAC taken twice. Now I am not going to take the H2O, but I will take the heavy water. Okay, heavy water, THF, remaining everything is same. And the second is NaBH4 OH-. So just to differentiate from the water, I had mentioned with a different color. So here the product what you are going to get is CH3CHODCH3. Okay. So the hydrogen in the alcohol part is always from the water molecule what you are using. Okay. Now this one only I am writing with a different part. Now again use HgOAC taken twice. Now use the H2O, same THF. Second one, now we will use the 1 minute, I will write down with NaBD4 and OH-. Means I am using here deuterium, because sodium borohydride is a reducing agent which actually reduces the carbon mercury bond, I said, no? So if you take this deuterium in the sodium borohydride, now the molecule you are going to get is CH3, CH, OH, CH2, D. So what did you observe? You had observed one thing, that whenever H2O and sodium borohydride normally they are using, one hydrogen we are getting to the CH2 double bonded carbon atom and OH group on the this particular carbon atom. But from where this hydrogen is coming, from where this OH is coming, and the hydrogen from the OH also. Then you just use the deuterated water. Then it was observed that the OH, what it is coming in the reaction, is always from the water, not from the NaBH4, because deuterium observed here, because deuterium is used here. And the second reaction, we used water here and deuterium here. Then they observed that deuterium is not on the OH part, but on the carbon part. So whatever the hydrogen here earlier we added, that is from the sodium borohydride, not from the water. Okay. So water OH will be added to the double bonded carbon with less number of hydrogens, and hydrogen is always added to the double bonded carbon with more number of hydrogens from NaBH4. Now I will take one more particular part here, that is HgOAc taken twice. Now you just see how I am using methyl alcohol. I am using, you must be very careful while observing the reactions, because it looks like the same but not like same. THF, and the second one is NaBH4 and OH minus. So now here you will get the molecule CH3 CH OCH3 and here CH3. Even if you want to test, you can just take the deuterium here, you will get the deuterium here. So this is a complete information about this reaction. So just remember this reaction, so you will get the complete idea, and from these two reactions you will get the how, whether the rearrangement is taking place or not. Hope you understood. Okay, let's plan some example reactions. So examples I'll mention here. This is the one molecule HgOAc taken twice, H2O, THF, NaBH4, OH minus. So we get this molecule, because OH will be added to the carbon with more number of substituents. CH2. Again, same reagent, just use. Third one. Same use. This is the beauty of this reaction. No rearrangement took place. If you use H2O and H2SO4, rearrangement takes place. I will write down that also here. So the product what we are going to get here is this one, not this one. So generally people discuss about this type of reactions. The moment they see, every time they write down the rearranged product, and the student get confused, and usually before 1 month of examination they used to ask us, sir, whether this product is correct or this product is correct. So they must know the actual reaction is, so that where rearrangement is taking place, where rearrangement is not taking place. So oxymercuration, demercuration do not include carbocation. No carbocation is the intermediate. And the next one is I'll take alcohol. Tetrahydrofuran, sodium borohydride, OH-. So you must observe the nucleophile, what we are using here. So OCH3. You just do not write down the rearranged products. So the molecule is now pH, CH3, CH, this is CH2, OC2, H5. So this is the reaction. I am going to discuss another hydration reaction, which is also a similar reaction without rearrangement gives a rearranged product. So the reaction is hydroboration oxidation. It is just similar to that of anti-Markovnikov's reaction. A reaction and similar to the anti-Markovnikov's rule. So here what the nucleophile in the sense, it may be OH-, it may be alkoxide, whatever we are using, is added to the double bonded carbon with more number of hydrogens. And the reaction is syn addition. The reaction is syn addition. Syn addition means both hydrogen and OH will be added on the same side of the double bonded carbon. Carbon atoms. You just see some of these reactions, how this hydroboration or oxidation reaction takes place. I'll take a molecule. You just take alkene. This is an alkene. So when this alkene, just observe the reaction very carefully. Take H2O. And concentrated H2SO4 means starting hydration reaction I am writing here. So we will get this product CHOH, CH3. Rearrangement is possible. Or else 1 minute, I will take erase this one. I will take another reactant because here rearrangement is not possible. So you just take this particular one, which is very important for us. Take H2O, concentrated H2SO4, CO and C. So we get the product like this. And just now oxymercuration demercuration reaction is used. OAC taken twice, H2O, THF, NaBH4, OH-. Then here the reaction beauty is with here rearrangement, here no rearrangement but Markovnikov's product. It also gives the Markovnikov's product but with rearrangement. Now, this particular reaction what we are discussing now is where we use the BH3THF. What did you use here? Mercuric state THF, water will be there everywhere. Okay. So, BH3 THF, they may give either this one or else they may give like B2H6THF, both are same. Diborane tetrahydrofuran is a solvent. This is the first part, and in second part we get the OH minus, H2O2 and H2O. Because oxidation, for oxidation purpose we want the H2O2. H2 is the basic nucleophile. So now you know the product what we are going to get. The product is here, no rearrangement takes place. Just you see, compare the reactions, how they are different. Rearrangement, no rearrangement, but anti-Marconi Coffs product means hydrogen is added to the double bonded carbon with less number of hydrogens and OH to the double bonded carbon with more number of hydrogens. So it is one of the this entire hydration reactions you have to understand together, then only you will not get confused what about the nature of these particular catalysts we are using. Okay, now I'll take some of the examples, so you just write down the products. So the first one is So every time you just take the BH3THF, this is the common one, and the second step, or they write this one also B2H6, B2H6, BH3 both are same, and second one is always, you have to remember the complete reagent, H2O2 and H2O, so that you will get the product like this. Now, the second one is, just now we have once discussed. The next one is, as this is a bit important because we are going to introduce the deuterium parts, means boron BD3 or B2D6 in the presence of THF, means I am introducing the deuterium to know the hydrogen in the OH group, whether it is from the these OHs or B2H6. Okay, OH minus, H2O2 and H2O. So when you write down the product, OH is always from the H2O2 OH minus only, and deuterium comes here because here we are adding one hydrogen, that is from the this boron diborane part. Now, let's try to know the stereochemistry of this reaction. As I said, this is a syn reaction. So, I will mention that once again. Hydroboration, oxidation, reaction occurs with syn addition. So, I will take the molecule. BH3THF or B2H6, next OH minus, H2O2, H2O. So, hydrogen OH minus comes from the same side. So, you can write down the molecule and Schumer's, you can write down. So, once if you write down the CH3 up, then obviously you have to write down this hydrogen is also up. Because both hydrogen and OH groups coming from the bottom side. So, that here more substituted carbon, so that hydrogen will be added, less substituted carbon OH comes. Similarly, now if you write down the methyl group down, then obviously you have to write down even hydrogen also down. You must remember this. So here we'll take color red pen. So that hydrogen if comes up here, OH group comes up, and the thing is both are enantiomers. Okay, so this is a syn addition process. Now I'll give some examples. Just solve those questions and send me WhatsApp message. So the problem is, please note down. So the first one is here. You just note down. Draw the products including stereochemistry where applicable. C2H5, BH3, THF, OH minus, H2O2, H2O. Second one is CH3 double bond, BD3, THF, OH minus, H2O2 and H2O. And third compound is PH CH double bond CH2, so that HGOAC taken twice, CH3OH, NaBH4 and OH minus. And the fourth one is HGOAC taken twice, H2O, NaBH4, OH minus. For all these reactions, you just send me the WhatsApp message after copying this.